create a website using W3 School Workspace. Recently, W3 School launched a services which is W3 School Workspace, and you can also create amazing types of websites using W3 School Workspace. You don't have to pay any money, but you can take the premium package also. But it is not necessary to run a single website. Okay, I'm going to give you a link in the video description. You can check that one. But this is not the sponsored video. I'm just making this video to give the information about the W3 School Workspace. W3 School is one of the amazing platform. Maybe you also know because it is providing different types of tutorial related with different types of programming languages such as JavaScript, PHP, MySQL, various types of programming language you can learn from the W3 School. But recently, the W3 School launched a platform that is W3 Workspace, which is very useful for the web developer. So without any late, let's begin our tutorial.
So guys, welcome to you all in my computer screen. So now you can see here I am inside the W3Spaces. So using the W3Spaces, you can also create amazing types of website. For example, I am going to show you a example. So now you can see here I am just opening a website. So now you can see here this was prepared a website using W3Spaces. Okay, so you can also create this type of website using W3Spaces. It is too much easy and simple, and today I'm going to teach you how to create those type of website using W3Spaces. So this features is recently launched by the W3 Schools. Maybe you also know about the W3 Schools. So you can use this feature in free of cost. Okay, so now you can see here it will give you the w3spaces.com subdomain, and it will give you the HTTPS encryption also, and you will get the 5000 requests per month, and you will get 1 GB data served per month, and you will get 100 MB storage and 5 MB files maximum and one space. Okay, so there are a few premium packages also available, but if you are running and if you want to learn, or if you want to run only one website, then in that case you don't have to purchase the premium package. It will okay with the free package also. Okay, so without any delay, let's begin. So first of all, you have to click in the sign up, or just you have to click in the get started for free. So I'm just clicking here. So in this time, I think I should to use a temporary email. So I'm just using a temporary email. So first of all, it is asking me my email ID, so I am just typing my email ID. Okay, so just wait for a moment. I am just using my temporary email from here. So now I'm just copying this email, and then after that I am just going here and I am using that email, and you can use your password also. So I am just using password. So when you are creating a password, you should to use the uppercase, lowercase and special type of character. After that, just you have to click in the sign up for free. Okay, so it is asking me my first name, right? So I'm just giving example website. Okay, and just you have to click in the continue, and after clicking the continue, so now you can see it is telling me that we have sent an email to my email ID. So I'm just going here, and now you can see W3 School sent me a email, and I'm just opening that email, and just you have to click in the verify email. So I'm clicking here, and now you can see here just telling me that my email is loading successfully, right? So I'm just clicking here, and now you can see here it is giving me the dashboard to create the website. Okay, so now you can see it is giving me the website, right? So there are various types of the available subject or tutorials and quizzes and exercises you will get from here also. Okay, there are various types of the quiz available, but okay, you can get the paid courses also from here. Okay, so from here you will get various types of the paid courses, different types of the HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and data analytics and Python, various types of the programming language related programs available, and the courses rate also available here. Okay, and I'm just clicking the back to main site. Okay, so I'm clicking in the back side, and you can take any of them, but in this time I'm just using the spaces. So now you can see here in the site of the spaces there is a new icon also available, right? So I'm just clicking here, and from here, so now you can see here it is asking me. Okay, so now after that, just you have to click in the get started, and you will get the 2GB data served per month and 100MB storage and 5MB files maximum. And I'm clicking here in the get started. And so if you want to use a template, just you have to choose start with template, otherwise just you have to click in the start with blank page. Okay, and I'm just using this one, and I'm just clicking in the continue. Okay, and now we can see there are various types of templates available, right? So you can choose any of them. So for example, if you want to choose this one, just you have to choose this one. Okay, so for example, if I want to use this one, start with portfolio, start with photographer, start with pizza. Okay, so there are various types of the templates available, but in this time I am just using this one, start with portfolio. And after that you have to click in the continue. So now after clicking in the continue, so now you can see it is asking me what do you want to call your spaces. So you can give your website name. So for example, I'm just example web.w3spaces.com. okay, then after that just you have to click in the continue. So it is telling the setting of spaces. So it is telling the great work. So now you can see inside here I have a website available, so I'm just clicking here, and from here, so I can click here. So now you can say I can edit and dip, I can do various types of things from here. Okay, so this is my website, and from here if I want to delete this one, I can delete this one. If I want to get a domain, I can click here. Okay, so if I want to upgrade this one, just you have to click the upgrade. Okay, but in this time I'm just clicking here, right? So that's why my website is looking like this. Okay, so after creating the website, so now we can say if you want to edit your all the files, okay, so for that one don't click here. Okay, so just you have to click in this icon. So here just you have to click here, and you will get all the files, right? So for example, there are various types of images available. Okay, so you can upload the files also. Okay, but I'm not uploading the file. If you want to edit this image, so for example, if I want to see the image, so now we can say this is the image, right? So if you want to edit this one, just you have to come here and you can use those images. Okay, but in this time if I want to edit the index.html, maybe, yeah, this is the main page, index.html, and the size is 13.84 KB. so if you want to edit this one, just you have to click here in the edit, and after this one, so it is loading again, and it is loading, right? Yeah, so now you can say you will get your source code, and you can edit your website. So for example, so now you can see here this is the image, right? So if I want to edit those images, so I have to come here, and now you can see there are various types of the images available, right? So if I want to change that one, so for example, I am just using a website, pexels.com. okay, so this website will provide you the royalty free images, right? So if I want to use this photo, just go here and right click, and just you have to click in the copy image address, and after that just come in your this editor. Then after that, just you have to paste that link. Okay, so from here if I paste that one, and if I click in the save, so if I refresh this one, so now you can see here the photo is changed, right? If I want to customize another picture, so for example, if I want to insert this image, just right click and just click in the copy image address. After that, just go to here and you have to paste that images link, and just click in the save. And again, if I refresh this one, So now you can see here the another image is also changing, right? So there are various photos available, so you can change those photos as per your requirement. So if I want to change this section, so there is about me, right? So just come here and just press Ctrl plus F and about me. Okay, so now you can see here is a about me section, right? So you can use ipsum lorem. Okay, yeah, from here you can use few text. So for example, I am just using those text, so I am just copying this I am just selecting this one and Control C and copying here, and I am just changing those content here and clicking in the save. And if I refresh this one, okay, so now we can see here all the text is changed, right? Okay, so in this way you can also change this one, so you can change all those things. Okay, so for example, if you want to change those things, just you have to come down and just come here. Now we can see here you can change your all those things. Okay, so for example, if you want to make it web development, and just you have to click in the save. And if you refresh this one, so this web design should be changed in the web development. So now we can see it is changing in the web development. So in this way you can also customize your website. Okay, so in this site you can directly click in this site. Okay, so it is not necessary to modify everything, but in this way you can also create amazing types of the website using the W3Spaces. You don't need a very high types of the programming language. If you have the basic programming language or HTML knowledge, then in that case you can easily edit the source code. So hoping that you get few ideas.
If you are getting still any kind of problems with the W3School workspace, let me know in the comment sections. I'll try to give answer of your each questions. Okay, and I'll come back with another new video. Until then, goodbye. See you again.